welcome to my channel. My name is Nelina and I'm doing a fox eyes makeup tutorial, and I did it a little differently because my eyes are smaller because I'm Asian, and the way everybody else does it is the same, but I did it to make my eyes appear larger even though we're doing like a smoky cat eye effect, which makes your eyes smaller. But my eyes being small already, I don't want to do that. So also my personality, I don't think shined through in this video because I was so concentrated on the makeup, because I haven't done a makeup tutorial in forever and I haven't done my makeup in forever. But I hope you like it, and if you do, like this video if you like this video. Okay, bye. So I did this brow already, and I'm gonna do this brow because I think the brows are important for this look, like, because I usually don't do it so straight, I do it more arched and like downwards, but with this look you want to like pull everything up like that, I guess. I'm gonna brush my brows up. My skin is terrible right now, so don't mind me. I'm gonna start filling it. So I'm gonna fill it kind of normal in the front area, and then when I get here I'm gonna start feathering it more outwards instead of downwards like my brow naturally goes. Now I'm gonna take this Anastasia brow duo and I'm gonna take the lighter shade and just go through the front and then make some feathery strokes over here. And then for the end of the brow, I'm gonna go over it with the dark and just go over what I just did. And I'm gonna take the spoolie and blend it upwards and kind of blend all the product together. And you see how it's kind of spotty? What I do is I brush all my hairs downwards, and then I'll take the lighter shade and just fill in those areas that are splotchy, and then I'll brush my brows upwards again. And then it's looking kind of messy right now, but I'm gonna take some concealer. You want to take a full coverage concealer to do this because you're going to be creating a shape for your brow that's not natural if your brows aren't naturally straight. I'm taking the Nars, and then I'm just gonna fill. I'm gonna line my brows normally in the front, and then when I get to the arch, I'm gonna make it go straighter rather than curve. And then I'm gonna blend it out. And for the top, I'm just gonna carve it like normal. Also, the brush I'm using is kind of little and tiny. It's the M213. And then I'm just gonna buff out those edges of the concealer with a random brush. And to create that bushier effect, I'm taking some gel and I'm just gonna brush my brows upwards. And that gives that fuller look, which I need because I do not have full eyebrows. And that's how I did my eyebrows. So now I'm gonna prime my eyelids, and I'm just gonna use some concealer because I don't have really any eye base because I'm a broke bitch and I can't afford it. I just took the same concealer that I used to carve my brows, and I just am gonna pat it and make it a smooth flat surface for my shadows to go on. And you wanna concentrate this too on the outside right here because that's where we're gonna be putting a lot of the shadow. For this look, I feel all of the brushes that I'm using are important in how it turns out. So I'm gonna use this Morphe brush. It's the M411 brush, and it's kind of a tapered blending brush, and it has this fine tip, can you see? And it's very fluffy. And for the eyeshadow, you can use whatever you have, just use like neutrals if you want. It's really about the technique that you use. But I'm gonna take the Kat Von D Lolita palette, and I really like this palette actually. It's not very popular, I don't see a lot of people using it, but it's a really good palette, and I think all of the purples in here are like cute and very blendable. And yeah, so I'm just gonna get this first shade. It's called Hermosura, I think. Gonna top off the excess, and then I'll zoom you in a little bit. So I'm gonna start on the outer V. And then once you get all the product down over there, I'm gonna start going upwards like a wing. And I'm going from the bottom of my eye, like right here, to the tip of my eyebrow. You can even use lighter shades than this one because this one's getting pretty dark already, but I like a lot of shadow. So, and I think if you blend it out, it'll be good. So So you can see it's already creating that winged effect. And I'm keeping this on the outer part of my lid. I'm not going in the middle because then that's gonna enclose your eye. So now you wanna check your eyes to make sure that they're even and they're at the same angle. I think mine are okay. Now I'm gonna take Con Amor and it's the one right next. Oh shit. Oh, I'm gonna take that super slightly because it's kind of darker than what I want. And I'm gonna tap off the excess a lot. And I'm gonna do the same technique that I did with the first shade. So I'm concentrating it on the outer part of my eyelid. And then once all the product is laid down, you wanna just flick it upwards. And that brush did most of the work for me. So now I'm gonna take Recuerdos and it's a darker purpley shade. Now I'm gonna take this with the small tiny blending brush. And this one is the Morphe E36. And I'm gonna tap off the excess again. And this time I'm only gonna concentrate it on the outer part of my eyelid, kind of acting as an outer eyeliner. I don't really want to drag this one up, just keep it concentrated right here, just so you get that smoky effect. Now I'm gonna take the first blending brush and I'm not gonna put any extra product on it. I'm just gonna blend it out. I'm gonna say right now, this look does not go well with my eyes because I have a flat face. And when I'm like this, you can't see, like I have hooded eyes, I think, kind of, and it doesn't look good. So that's something I'm insecure about. But anyways, we're done with like the eyes. Actually, no. So now I'm gonna take this deep purple shade and it's called Eterno, I think. And I'm actually gonna take that with a liner brush. I don't know, this is what it says. This is what brush I'm using, but just any small eyeliner brush. And I'm gonna take that shade and I'm gonna run it along my lash line, just very precisely. You wanna get as close to the lash line as you can. And then when I go inside here, I'm actually gonna go kind of in my waterline with that shadow instead of on the lid, just cause I have small eyes. And if I were to do that, it would enclose it more. So this is what I'm using instead of eyeliner, just so that I can maintain that smoky effect. Now I'm gonna take this wider shade and I'm gonna put that all over my lid. It's called Promesa. I'm taking that with a flat blending brush just so that it's more airy and doesn't pack on too much product. And I'm just gonna put that on my eyelid just to brighten up that area a little bit. And I'm only putting it on the inner part of my eyelid and I'm not covering up any of that work we just did with the wing. Also, if you see a bump right here, I've had that pimple forever. It's not me like being bad at blending, although I am pretty bad at blending because I can be impatient, but that's what it is. Don't come at me. So now I'm gonna take some black eyeliner and I'm gonna line my upper waterline. I don't really know what it's called, but I'm just gonna do that just to make it more smoky. So now I'm gonna use some mascara and I'm using the Roller Lash from Benefit. And I'm just gonna put my mascara like normal. Now I'm gonna take some lashes. These lashes are Miami. These, oh my gosh. I'm so bad at makeup tutorials now. These are, oh my gosh. These are Miami lashes. And I cut them in half. They're not preferred to do this look because they're like very dramatic and obviously it's not gonna blend into my natural lashes as well as like Ardell Wispies. That's what I would use for this, but that's all I got. When I tried this look yesterday and I put it on, and if you can see, I kind of cut the middle so that it gives like less harshness to like where my natural lashes and where my falsie is. If that makes sense, I don't even know what I'm saying. So I'm just gonna put some glue and let it dry. In the meanwhile, I'm gonna do my foundation, and today I'm gonna use the Laura Mercier Flawless Fusion Ultra Longwear Foundation in the shade Chai. And guess what? I actually cleaned my brushes for the first time in like 6 months. So I'm just gonna pump that directly on there and I'm gonna buff it in. This is the M439 brush from Morphe. And I'm gonna put some concealer. I'm using the same concealer as before, the Nars Radiant Creamy Concealer. And I'm gonna put that on all the highlighting spots because I feel like this look is very important to highlight those areas. And then putting a little bit over here to draw attention to the cheekbones and bring them forward. And I'm gonna buff it out with an E8 brush from Morphe. And I'm gonna put my lashes on now. So, do you see how the lashes instantly give me that, like, fox effect? I personally don't like this on me, but I'm doing a tutorial on it because it's popular right now. So, to set my face, I'm using Laura Mercier Loose Translucent Setting Powder. No, why? If you hear my cousins yelling out there, they're fighting. I don't know if you can hear it, but I could definitely hear them. And I'm just going to mind my own business and set my foundation and concealer with this. For bronzer, I'm using the Fenty Beauty Bajan Gyal bronzer, and I'm gonna use MAC Peach's blush. And I feel like this look, you really wanna be precise and contour, because it gives that dimension and shape to your face that pulls it upwards and makes you look snatched. So for that, I'm using the M523 brush, and I'm just gonna start with little strokes, and then I'm gonna blend it out slowly, keeping it in that same area. And I'm also gonna bronze my forehead just so that it looks a little more even. And also, I have a big forehead, so I might as well. And a little on my jawline. I don't usually contour my nose, but I contoured it ever so slightly because I really don't know how. And I'm gonna use the same powder brush to do my blush just because it spreads it evenly and it's really soft. I'm gonna put a little bit on my nose, on my forehead, chin, just everywhere to give my face some color. And now I'm gonna set my face using the Morphe setting spray. And before that dries, I'm gonna put my highlight on with a M510 brush, and I'm gonna use Becca Champagne Pop Highlight, and I'm gonna put that directly on my cheekbones. Not gonna be messy with it, I'm just gonna put it in this area. I'm gonna put a little bit on the cupid's bow, and I'm gonna take a little brush and I'm gonna put some down the bridge of my nose and on the tip, and a little bit on my brow bone, and a little bit in my inner corner. Typically people don't, I don't think this requires a shiny inner corner, but I personally have little eyeballs, so I want to brighten them up as much as I can since I'm like making it smoky over here, so it's making my eyes look smaller. For lips, I want to keep with that nudie mauve color scheme that I have going on. So I'm going to use the Kylie Cosmetics lip liner in 20, and it's kind of sticking out a little bit. And I'm going to take Do you hear that? He's crazy. And I just used the same lipstick that came in the lip kit. And I forgot to do this, but lastly, I'm gonna put mascara on my bottom lashes. I'm gonna go outwards instead of directly down. So this is the finished look, but if you wanna elevate this look, you can do your hair back. Why am I sweating? I am sweating so hard right now. I've been here for 22 minutes. So I am going to part my hair on this side, and I'm gonna take my bangs out, and I'm just gonna ponytail this up. I don't know what kind of brush this is called, but this is the one that smooths your hair down. Ponytailing your hair like that gives you an instant facelift. Like, I don't know if you can tell a difference, but I can tell a difference, and I think it looks really good. And to elevate this look even more, I'm gonna put my hair in. This is gonna take a while. So after 30 minutes of putting it on, I'm so over this and it's not perfect, so don't examine my ponytail too hard. Whenever I put this ponytail on, I get so stressed out and it makes me so mad. But anyways, this is the finished look, and I think that it looks so cute. So anyway, thanks for watching my video, and I hope you liked it. Subscribe if you want. Like this video if you like this video. And if you recreate this look, tag me. So yeah, thanks for watching. Bye! Thank you.